some of your work with the fasting, so-called fasting mimetics, like spermidine, hydroxycitrate that you've done. Maybe can you kind of just briefly explain, let's start with spermidine. What is spermidine? What does it do?
Well, I will first start to explain what are these fasting mimetics, as you say, and caloric restriction mimetics, as we say. Right. So the CRMs, caloric restriction mimetics, are actually inducing the same biochemical changes in the cells as would do starvation or fasting. So we have been discussing on the importance of acetyl-CoA and protein deacetylation resulting from the depletion of acetyl-CoA in the context of fasting. And caloric restriction mimetics similar induce deacetylation reactions to stimulate autophagy. And this can be actually achieved in three different ways. First, you simply inhibit the generation of acetyl-CoA. The enzyme that generates acetyl-CoA in our cells, the most important one for the cytosolic pool, is ATP citrate lyase, and hydroxycitrate, or pharmacological compounds that inhibit this enzyme, cause acetyl-CoA depletion, deacetylation, and autophagy. And you can have the same effect by inhibiting the protein acetyl transferases. Some of them have been identified, like EP300, which appears extremely important for autophagy regulation. And specific inhibitors of EP300, such as spermidine, a natural compound, or C6-4-CIT, which is a pharmacological compound specifically designed for this function, they can also cause deacetylation and autophagy. And finally, it is possible to activate deacetylases, so enzymes that remove acetyl groups from proteins and cause hypoacetylation and autophagy. And one example that is well known is resveratrol, contained in red wine, that induces autophagy through this pathway. So all these agents, caloric restriction mimetics, have different molecular targets, but activate of autophagy by a final common pathway.
The protein acetylation seems like that.
Yes, exactly.
Pathway. Okay. The so with some of the major ones that you've worked with, spermidine. I've read quite a bit about spermidine. I know it's found in high concentrations in natto, Japanese fermented soybean that doesn't taste that great, but. I've seen studies about aging, you know, giving it to even, you know, aging mice or something can extend their lifespan. Is that true?
So spermidine, to come to the source of spermidine, is contained in the nuclei of all kinds of cells. So in the nucleoid of bacteria, but also in the nuclei from yeast cells or from plant cells or animal cells. So all food items that contain nuclei, cells, are actually containing spermidine, although there are large variations in the content. So we have to know that spermidine also is volatile and accounts for the smell of sperm. So it is frequently found in food items that have some kind of smell, like natto, or durian fruit, or fermented cheese when it is generated from non-pasteurized sources and very rich in bacteria and fungi that are contributing to the fermentation process, which is, of course, smelly cheese. And it's also quite abundant in some vegetables and food where the scent is more agreeable to most people because it is complex to other molecules that reduce its volatility. So spermidine has the capacity to induce autophagy when it is taken up with food or with the drinking water when we treat mice. It can also be injected, of course. It is produced by our microbiota. So one third of the spermidine in our body is probably produced in the intestine, and you can manipulate the microbiome to increase its production of polyamines, including spermidine.
Through what, probiotics or through?
Yes, yeah.
So you know what strains of bacteria?
Yeah, there's a Japanese group that has been publishing that specific bacteria overproducing polyamines can be used to reduce the development of colon cancer or to reduce aging.
Wow, fascinating. Mm-hmm. That's very interesting. And you've shown with the spermidine, I know we have limited time here, with the spermidine, it's been shown to, was it spermidine or hydroxycitrate, I think, that was shown to synergize with, like you were mentioning before, the chemotherapeutic?
Yeah, both of them, actually.
Both. Okay.
So the mechanism is that when you combine chemotherapy with caloric restriction mimetics, all the caloric restriction mimetics that I mentioned, including spermidine and hydroxycitrate and resveratrol, will enhance the anti-cancer immune response that makes the therapy durable. So we have been able to show that inhibition of autophagy in the malignant cells or destruction of the extracellular ATP that is released as a result of autophagy is sufficient to abolish the favorable interaction between caloric restriction mimetics and chemotherapy. And similarly, actually, it is sufficient to remove T cells from the system, and you will lose any kind of tumor growth reduction induced by chemotherapy combined with caloric restriction mimetics as a proof that the cellular immune response is actually decisive for therapeutic outcome.
Wow, that's really quite promising, I think, for, you know, at least in the clinic, if you can somehow now test whether or not these caloric restriction or fasting mimetics work in conjunction with some of these immunotherapies, that would be fantastic. Mm. But I want to ask you one last thing too about some of these fasting mimetics. Like, if I were to just supplement with hydroxycitrate, for example, or if there were a spermidine supplement, and I was still eating a normal, you know, healthy diet, not caloric restricted and not fasting, Do you think that would be sufficient to induce autophagy in?
Well, I can respond for mice.
Okay.
This is
How about
certainly
in mice?
The case. I don't know about humans because we have no clinical studies.
So in mice, it does.
And in mice, you actually can give a combination of high-fat diet that usually would cause obesity with spermidine to reduce weight gain through mechanisms that we don't understand and that we believe to be autophagy-dependent but have to elucidate in some molecular detail.
That's very cool. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to look up those strains of bacteria, you know, to see, you know, can I eat fermented foods to increase that population and get more spermidine, you know, things like that would be very interesting to me as useful little tools.